We are here to pay respect to our departed comrades who protected our safety and freedom during World War I. This war was a war to end all wars. At this time, we will have words of welcome from Mayor Frank Nunziato, followed by words from John Polanski, and a proclamation by Post Commander 109, Bob Robert Texas.
Thank you, everybody. People have described what's going on right now as a war. That's not close to what these gentlemen experienced in their lives. We felt that this day was not supposed to be let go. I know we canceled a lot of our events, but we would not cancel this one. We honor you, and we appreciate you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, governing body, Mayor. We can go beyond. Today we recognize an unfortunate fact of life. Our beloved country was formed and is protected by the blood of our warriors. As unfortunate as this is, we can be thankful that throughout our history, Americans have answered the call every time our way of life has been threatened. But today should not only be about sorrow we feel at their loss, and not only about mourning. What it should also be about was best expressed by General George Patton back in 1944. At a military cemetery in France, looking out across a field filled with rows of crosses, marking the graves of men who just days before had been part of his 3rd Army Division, Patton uttered, "We should thank God that such men live." And that is what this very special day is all about, showing gratitude that such brave men and women have lived, and to pay tribute to those heroic patriots who bravely rose up and fought for something greater than themselves, protecting a home to which they never returned. They sacrificed everything for the noblest of causes, and it is up to all of us to carry their memory forward in an effort to acknowledge a debt that can never truly be repaid. We can go beyond tradition, beyond remembering, and beyond mourning. Today, we can work together to preserve this, the country they died for, by building a better nation, each and every day, come what may. They gave up their todays for our tomorrows. Let us share their message of dedication and determination to the generation in uniform today and to the generations who will serve tomorrow, because there is no greater way to honor the memory of those who have secured it than to pass it on with hope. Thank you all for your time and attention. May God bless you all today. May God also bless those preserving our freedom, health, and general welfare today, whether in uniform or not.
How are you?
I'm feeling very good.
I was going to say, the last time we spoke, we were just hiding behind this.
I know.
However, it is amazing that we're here today. You're here today to share this with us. As the Grand Marshal, as many of you may or may not know, every year the parade post to post circulates, it rotates amongst the 3 posts in Rutherford. This year, post 453 with Commander Gunn and his crew, his post, doing a lot of the work. Some of it we're not going to experience because of what we're going through today. But this is all you're doing. So thank you for putting it all together. And thank you for bringing this gentleman here as the Grand Marshal. So this is the Mayor's commendation presented to William Galloway, Grand Marshal, 2020 Rutherford Memorial Day Parade, in recognition of your years of service in the United States Army, and the many years of dedication that you continue to provide to the Borough of Rutherford. On behalf of all the residents of our community, I extend congratulations and grateful appreciation. Signed, Mayor Frank Nunziato, May 25th, 2020.
I'm here, and thank you, everyone. Thank you again. Once again, I would like to thank the mayor and council and the policemen and all those who played the viable part in this observation. I just happen to be one of the columns that's in this, observation. But also I would like to thank those that I did not have the opportunity to thank for placing flags on the hillside grave. We received the flags late, but yet we did this, we got the job done. Today, we have gathered to remember and remember of those who lost their lives at sea and here today at World War I. Let's not forget. Let's not forget about those who made the supreme sacrifice in World War II, Korea, Vietnam, Lebanon, Grenada, Panama, Gulf War, and Global War on Terror, and others who continue to fall by an active war. Let's have a moment of silence. Unseen danger. As we depart to see each other once safe at home, these and all the blessings I ask in the name of Jesus the Christ. Amen. Cover. A hand of a heart salute, hand or a heart salute. Present arms, taps. Conclude our Memorial Day observation. Once again, thanks all for attending.